keep your cash, I'm not that broke. I won't sign no contracts, I do $1 million canceled. Stealing people's dreams, how can you sleep? It's a rap pose.
Now you're gonna see me, cioè you're gonna see that I write on the board. So let me choose a color, this color. So can you see me right?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the first lesson of Italian. So let's do a fast introduction. And for example, in Italian is like in Spanish. Every time something ends with the letter O is masculine, and something that end with the letter A is feminine. For example, let's write something in Italian. Let's write casa. Casa is like in Spanish, it means house.
Mm.
And you see, end with the letter A, so it's feminine.
Okay.
Instead, for example, if I write gatto, gatto means cat. That end with the letter O, so is masculine.
Masculine.
So then there is the article. The article in English is the, and we have a masculine article is il, and feminine article is la. So these, let's write here masculine when ending O, and feminine when ending A. So because casa is feminine, because ending A, you gotta use also the feminine article, see? La casa. Instead, when something is ending O, like gatto is masculine, you gotta use the masculine article, il gatto. Does it make sense? Mm.
I got the O, anything ending with O means masculine.
Yes.
And then A means what? You said what A means what? Feminine.
Feminine, yes. Mm-hmm. Also, let me tell you something about the pronunciation. Do you speak Spanish? Do you know some Spanish?
No.
So in Italian, it's very important because the five vowels are pronounced differently than in English. And the pronunciation of those are the five vowels, the five letter vowels. In Italian, this letter, you always pronounce it very open, like in the word America. You always say A, you never say E, because in English you pronounce A sometimes. This letter in Italian is always pronounced A, open. Then this letter, you pronounce it like you pronounce this letter in English. This is A. This letter you pronounce like pronounce this letter in English. This is E, it's never I. And then never I, it's only A. And then there is O, like in the name Oscar, you don't say O, you say O. And then U is like in the name Uma Thurman. I don't know if you know the actress Uma Thurman. So after me, say the five vowel like A, E,
E,
I,
I,
O,
O,
U.
U.
Very good. So now let me go on with the noun and the article, and then we read something to be able to introduce yourself. So, for example, here, let me see. Okay. So I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna write nouns here, and I do this across, and here I'm gonna write article. Article, and I'm gonna write this cross. This cross in this corner is masculine singular, in this corner is feminine singular, in this corner is masculine plural, and feminine plural. So masculine plural and feminine plural, same here. And now you understand what I'm doing. So masculine singular, feminine singular, masculine plural, and feminine plural. So now here in the one of the nouns, I write O, A, I, E. And the article il, la, I, le. So let's start to write nouns. For example, let's write muro. Muro means wall. Then we saw already casa, no? That means a house. Then, car. Car in Italian is macchina. They say macchina. Macchina means car. Then we have, let me think something else. Cucina. Cucina is kitchen. Kitchen, then baño, that is like in Spanish, but is spelled differently. Baño is the restroom. And then we can do scuola. Scuola is written like that. Scuola is a school. So let's see those words. Let's see the article. So muro. End with O or A? With, cioè, watching at the ending of muro, do you think it's masculine or you think it's feminine? Muro.
I think
you go here, masculine singular, see? O, masculine singular.
Okay, masculine.
See, cioè, I mean, here where there is written O, because in this corner is masculine singular. Feminine singular, masculine plural, and feminine plural. So you take the article from the same corner where there is masculine singular. So you say il muro. Il muro means the wall. Il muro. Then you see this one, la casa, okay? Yeah. Casa ending A, so is here, is feminine singular. So the article is in the corner of feminine singular, la casa. The same for macchina. Macchina means car. So every time ending O, the article is il. And every time ending A, the article is la. Because here, masculine singular, this corner. And for the article, you go to take the same corner.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Does it make sense?
It is. It just takes a while.
Yeah. Say il muro. Il, say, repeat after me, il muro.
Il muro.
Good pronunciation. La casa.
La casa.
Good. La macchina.
La macchina.
For example, in Italian, CH is K. You know, here in America, you know, they say bruschetta. You know, this bruschetta, that things with bread that you make like pizza, no?
Mm-hmm.
It's wrong, it's no bruschetta, it's bruschetta. They pronounce it wrong. You never heard people say bruschetta?
No.
No? Well, so let's go on. Cucina, ending in A, is la cucina. So say la cucina.
La cucina.
Then bagno, it means restroom. So do you think that is la o il? Here in front of bagno, do you think you have to put il o la? Watching at the ending.
Il.
Exactly. Yeah, correct. Yes, because it's masculine, il. And then we have a scuola that end in a. So, do you think you have to put il o la in front of scuola?
I think l.
Yes, is la, because it's feminine, la scuola. So, say il bagno.
Il bagno.
La scuola.
Il bagno, la scuola.
Then to make the noun plural is no like in English that you add s. to make the noun plurals, you know what means plurals, no? It's like to say the wall, the walls, when they are many, that in English you add S. In Italian, so you have to move down in these things. For example, if you want to say the walls, plural, you have to substitute O with E, because masculine plural is muri. I muri. So you have to use the one down here. But, you know, this is what I wanted, just to show some grammar. But let me show you also a little bit how to speak in Italian. So if you meet someone that you don't know, you can say ciao, because ciao means I, and it means also goodbye.
Goodbye, okay.
It means what? So you can say ciao, and then you can also say come stai. How are you? Come stai, it means... Sì, is come, it means how. How, and here there is the subject, vabbè, how are you?
How are you?
Yes. So then you can ask, ciao, come stai? And the person who answer, you can say, sto bene. Ciao, come stai? Let's answer with another call. Yes, ciao, come stai is a way to say, hey, how are you?
How are you?
Exactly. So the person can say, sto bene, sto bene, grazie.
Sto bene.
Grazie means thank you. Sto bene. Yeah, sto bene means I'm fine. And grazie means thank you.
Thank you.
So bene, grazie. E tu? And you? Tu means you. And the other person can answer. Anch'io sto bene.
Sto bene.
Grazie. So let's do this little conversation. I'm gonna be blue and you're gonna be red. Let's say ciao, come stai?
Sto bene.
Grazie.
Yeah.
Sei grazie.
Ok, so sto bene. Grazie.
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 Good. Yes, in Italian you have to read all the vowels. Sto bene, grazie. E tu?
Oh, sto bene. Sto bene. Grazie. Tu. Mm-hmm. What is the meaning of e tu?
E tu means and you.
Oh,
and you?
Sto bene.
Yes.
Grazie, e tu?
Yes, so I'm fine, thank you. And you?
And you?
Okay. And I say sto bene, grazie.
Okay.
So, yes.
Grazie, e tu?
Now you do all the blue and I do the red. So you meet me in the morning and you tell me, ciao, come stai?
Ciao. Ciao. Come and stai.
Sto bene, grazie. E tu?
Sto bene, grazie.
Yes, very good. So now I just want to show you a little bit to say good morning. Good morning is buongiorno. Good morning, buongiorno. Then buongiorno, buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno. Because buon, the word buon means good.
Okay, buon.
Buon o buono, it can be also buono. But in this case is buono because they put it together to another word. Because the word giorno is day. Giorno means day. So good day, basically.
Yeah.
Then they also say good afternoon. After 12.
Buono, say the other one again. Buono.
This one. Buongiorno. Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Yes. in Italian, you have to pronounce all the vowels. So, U and O. Buon giorno.
Buon giorno.
Perfect. Buongiorno. Yes.
Very good.
Buongiorno. And if you go to Italy, start to go around and say buongiorno. And people is going to answer you buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Then there is buon pomeriggio. Buon pomeriggio.
Now
I help you. That means good afternoon. Pomeriggio is afternoon. Buon pomeriggio. Pomeriggio.
Okay, buon pomeriggio.
Very good. That means good afternoon. Buon pomeriggio.
Buon pomeriggio.
Pomeriggio is afternoon. And then another is buonasera. Buonasera, good evening.
Good evening. Buonasera.
Oh, you say it very well, buonasera. Then there is another, there is buonanotte. Buonanotte. Ma you will say only when you go to sleep.
Which one?
Buonanotte. This one that I'm writing now, that means good night.
Buonanotte.
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 Yes, I do the moon here, you see. Buonanotte. So you understand this one is only when you go to sleep. So if you go out in the evening in a restaurant, you don't say buonanotte, because buonanotte means you are going home.
Home to sleep, yeah.
Yes, you say buonasera.
Buonasera.
When you say buonanotte means you finish your day and you are going home.
We're going to sleep, yeah.
Yes. Only when you go to sleep you say buonanotte.
Okay.
And this that I draw here is la luna. La luna. The moon. The moon is la luna. Don't you like the sounds of Italian? It's so beautiful. La luna.
La luna. Buonasera.
Let's repeat then, and then I show you something else. So, buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Buon pomeriggio.
Buon pomeriggio.
Buonasera.
Buonasera.
Buonanotte.
Buonanotte.
Now, let's say a little bit, you can, and all this is recorded, so I'm going to send you on your telephone the link for the recording, okay?
Okay.
So when you see, for example, you say.
So I'm gonna see the writing.
Yes.
Then I can.
After we finish, after 1 hour, because I have to prepare it, I'm going to send on your telephone your number a link. And when you click the link, you're gonna see all this that we made recorded. You can see it many times. So, yeah. Mi chiamo Adeline. Your name is Adeline, right?
Adeline.
Mi chiamo Adeline. In Italian, your name is Adelina. In Italian, your name is Adelina, and then Italian will call you Lina.
Lina.
So, mi chiamo Adeline. It means my name is Adeline. Mi chiamo Adeline is my name. My name is Adeline. And then you can also say piacere. Piacere, that means nice to meet you.
Piacere.
Piacere, nice to meet you.
Is it piacere?
Yes, piacere.
Oh,
piacere. Yes.
Piacere.
Nice to meet you.
Okay. My name is Adeline, is what?
Yes. My name, mi chiamo, this one, mi chiamo Adeline. It means my name is Adeline.
Okay. Mi chiamo Adeline.
Yes, piacere.
Mi chiamo Adeline.
So my name is Adeline. Nice to meet you.
Oh, okay.
In Italian,
Adeline, piacere.
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 Very good, yes. Mi chiamo Adeline, piacere.
Okay. And then, Adeline, piacere.
Yes.
Adeline, piacere.
Come ti chiami? What's your name? Come means how you call yourself. Come ti chiami? What's your name? Means come ti chiami? What's your name? So try, come ti chiami?
Come ti chiami? What is your name?
Exactly. And
come
I
ti chiami?
Exactly. What's your name? Mi chiamo, I say mi chiamo Laura. Mi chiamo Laura, it means my name is Laura. Piacere.
Piacere.
Yes. So let's do this little conversation. You're gonna say the first three. So you're gonna say this, this, and this. And I say the last two.
Okay. Mi chiamo Adeline. Okay, let me start again.
Yes.
Mi chiamo Adeline. Piacere.
And then come ti chiami?
Come ti chiami?
Yes.
Come ti chiami?
Repeat it all one more time.
Okay. Come ti chiami?
Yes, so I say mi chiamo Laura, piacere.
Okay, so come ti chiami?
Yes, come ti chiami is what's your name? And I tell you, mi chiamo Laura, piacere. This is a name.
Yeah. Come ti chiami?
Come ti chiami? Mi chiamo Laura, piacere.
Okay. How about the first one?
Mi chiamo, chiamare, chiamo. Chi?
Mi chiamo Adeline.
Good.
Mi chiamo Adeline.
Do you like Lina? If Italian call you Lina, you like Lina?
Yeah.
So you can say mi chiamo Lina.
Mi chiamo Lina.
Sì.
Piacere.
And then you can say come ti chiami?
Oh, come ti chiami?
Mi chiamo Laura. Piacere. Good. Now let's go and see something a little bit more difficult. Let me exit from here. Okay, so here is inside here, and then here is in Italian.
What is your name again?
Come ti chiami?
Oh, come ti chiami?
Yes. Come ti chiami?
Come ti chiami?
Yes.
My name is Adeline.
Mi chiamo Adelina.
Oh, mi chiamo
Adelina.
Mi chiamo Adeline.
Yes.
Adelina.
So here, okay, I don't want to do this because it's too. So can you see this picture? It's a picture of two people.
Yeah.
But before to show you this, I want to show you something else. Let's do a little bit the subject. You know that in English you say I. Yeah. I in Italian is io.
Right.
So I is io. Then in English you have you. You see that I'm writing? Can you see that I'm writing here next to the picture of this? No.
Oh, okay. It's now coming. Yeah, I see I.
Yes. Then you In Italian is tu. Then don't worry, you cannot remember everything. Just try to understand and you can watch the recording. Then in English you say he, no? If he's a man, you say he, right? In Italian, he is lui.
Oh, he is lui.
Lui. Instead, she. She in Italian is lei. Then there is we. We in Italian is noi. Then there is you, y'all. Are you saying, are you from the South?
No, from here.
Ah, you're from New York, so you say use guys. Use guys, that is plural, is voi. And instead, they is loro. So don't worry, because to memorize it takes a while. But I just wanted to show you. When you say I is io.
Yeah.
Tu is you. Then you say lui, he, lei. Let's repeat at least those ones. So, io. Io sono Lina. I am Lina. So let's read one second one of those and then we finish just to show you how we work. So this guy here under the picture is saying ciao. So this guy, you see here that he say ciao. Is what we did before. Ciao, mi chiamo Marco Casciani. Hi, my name is Marco Casciani and sono italiano. So sono means I am. Sono is I am. So ciao, mi chiamo Marco Casciani e sono italiano. Repeat. Ciao.
Ciao.
Mi chiamo Marco Casciani.
Ciao, mi chiamo.
Mi chiamo Marco Casciani.
Ciao, mi chiamo Marco Casciani.
Yes, mi chiamo.
Mi chiamo Marco Casciani, that's the name.
Yes, that's the name. E sono italiano.
E sono italiano.
This A means and. So, what he said? What he said, this guy? Ciao, I, and then what he said? Mi chiamo Marco Casciani. So my name is Marco Casciani and I am Italian. So it's difficult.
Yeah.
It's difficult for you. Do you think it's difficult?
Oh, yeah, in the beginning it's not a joke.
Cioè, to learn a language it takes a while, but if you decide to learn a language, you take one lesson a week and you watch the recording every week, you learn. So, sono, you don't have to do it, but if you decide to take the course, this is a free demonstration, you don't have obligation. Anyway, I'm gonna send you the recording for sure, and then later tonight I'm gonna send you a link. If you wanna take the course, you can follow the instruction. If you decide to take the course, there will be 10 lessons of 1 hour that you take once a week. And then after you took your lesson, you have to watch the recording that I send you on your telephone every week. You just watch the recording one, twice, and if you do that every week, you learn. Everybody learn with this method. Then he says, sono di Verona. Sono di Verona means I am from Verona.
Sono di Verona.
Yes, I am from Verona. Verona is a city in Italy. You can say also, sono di, which city are you? New York? Which
Yeah.
you are from New York?
I'm from Georgia.
Oh, you are from Georgia, so you can say sono di Atlanta. Your city is Atlanta. You from Atlanta?
Atlanta.
So sono, you can say ciao, mi chiamo o sono Lina. Ciao, sono Lina e sono di Atlanta. I am Lina and I am from Atlanta. You see that I wrote it here in white. So, ciao, sono Lina.
Ciao, sono Nina.
Lina, your name,
Yeah,
e
yeah.
sono di Atlanta. So, when you say sono Lina, it means I am Lina. When you say
Yeah.
mi chiamo Lina, it means my name is Lina.
Oh, if you say so,
If you say
sono.
sono Lina,
Lina.
that is I am Lina.
I am Lina,
If
solo Nina.
Lina, instead if you say mi chiamo, that we did it before, if you say mi chiamo Lina, that instead means my name is a little different. My name is Lina.
Elena.
So sono Lina e mi chiamo Lina.
Yeah.
You can say what you want, is the same.
Anyone, yeah.
Yeah, what you prefer. There are two ways in English too. I can say I am Laura or I can say my name is Laura, is the same.
Yeah.
So let's finish here. I hope you're not too bored. So he say ho 20 anni. This is means I am 20. You use it to say your age. But anyway, we can stop here for the first lesson. How do you feel? You think it's difficult?
No. Slow, slow. We only did 30 minutes, right? We haven't done 1 hour.
Well, if you are okay, we can do something else because this is grammar, and then we do also other activities.
Yeah, I got this one. I got sono Lina. Oh, mi chiamo Lina. So I
Yeah.
got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the
Sono
next
Lina.
sono Lina o
Mi chiamo Lina.
mi chiamo Lina. Sono Lina o
Yes.
mi chiamo Lina. So here there is another sentence. This ho 20 anni. But before to show you this, we have to see the numbers. So let me show you the numbers very fast in Italian. So let me write. Oh, there is also the alphabet. Yeah, this is a small conversation. Okay, now I'm gonna write the number here. So this is uno, uno, due, tre, quattro, cinque, sei, sette, otto, nove, dieci. So say after me, uno,
Uno,
due,
due,
tre,
tre,
quattro,
quattro,
cinque,
cinque,
sei,
sei,
sette,
sette,
otto,
otto,
nove,
nove,
dieci.
dieci.
Hey, good. So you say the number from 1 to 10.
uno.
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 Uh-huh. Uno.
Due.
Due.
Uno, because this letter is U.
U.
Yes. Like in uno. English, uno. Due.
Tre.
Tre. Very good.
Quattro.
Very good. Cinque.
Cinque.
Cinque. Sei.
Sei.
Sette.
Sette.
Otto.
Otto.
Nove.
Nove.
Dieci.
Dieci.
Good. So, here, in order to get confident with the pronunciation, your pronunciation is very good already. You see, even in the name of people, the name that end in O are masculine. You see, mm-hmm. In Italians, everything that end in O is masculine, and anything that end in I is feminine. Even the name of women, those are name of women. Instead, in the other list, there are the name of men. So repeat some name after me just to work with your pronunciation. Alberto.
Alberto.
Antonio.
Antonio.
Carlo.
Carlo.
Emilio.
Emilio.
Enrico.
Enrico.
Franco.
Franco.
Giacomo.
Giacomo.
Giorgio.
Giorgio.
Ah, this is ending E, but this is John. Giovanni is John.
John?
Yes, is the translation of John. In Italian is Giovanni.
Giovanni.
Giuseppe.
Giuseppe.
Lorenzo.
Lorenzo.
Luigi.
Luigi.
Do you know the Italian name?
No.
Do you know how they sound, the Italian name?
No.
No, you don't like them?
No.
You prefer English name, English sounding name, names?
No.
Okay, so Angela.
Angela.
Anna.
Anna.
Antonella.
Antonella.
Bettina.
Bettina.
Carla.
Carla.
Caterina.
Daniela.
Try to say, to read by yourself. What this one?
Daniela.
Very good. You see, you learn how to read. Try this one.
Elena.
Very good. This is a little more difficult. Try.
Elisabetta.
Yes, Elisabetta. Elisabetta.
Elisabetta. Okay.
Yes.
This one is Franca.
Yes, very good. This?
Francesca.
Francesca.
Oh, Francesca. Giovanni.
Giovanna is Joan. In English is Joan.
Joan. Mm-hmm.
Yes. So now let's go a little bit on this side. And let's read the alphabet, okay? So lesson number one, the Italian alphabet, that is this one. So after me, A.
A.
B. C.
Mm-hmm.
D.
D.
E.
E.
F. G.
G.
This letter H is called H. H is the letter H. H.
H.
I.
I.
L.
L.
M.
N.
N. O.
O.
P.
P.
Q.
Q.
R.
R.
S.
S.
T.
U.
U. B. Z.
V.
All these letters are not in the Italian alphabet. These are English letter. They don't exist in the Italian alphabet. I also want to show you some way that you can use to say stuff in general.
In Italian, like maybe.
Yes, like for example, I'm hungry, I'm thirsty, to be able to say that stuff. Okay, so this is a picture. It was okay. So here, at the top here, now I'm going to write a verb. This verb is the verb to have. So to have at the present. So in Italian, in English is I have, you have, then you have he has and she has. Then there is we have, you have, that will be used guys, you have, they have. So let's see what are all these in Italian. This verb to have, let's do the arrow. So you see the correspondent in Italian. So in Italian is to have is avere. Avere is to have. I have is io ho. Instead, you have is tu hai. He has is lui ha. She has is lei ha. We have is noi abbiamo. You have is voi avete. Mm-hmm. And they have is loro hanno. So, for example, io ho, it means I have. So you understand, right, what means all that. There is the translation in English. So let's see, let's say, repeat after me, avere.
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 Yes, io ho. The H is mute in Italian, so say io ho.
Io ho.
Tu hai.
Tu hai.
Lui ha.
Lui ha.
Lei ha.
Lei ha.
Noi abbiamo.
Noi abbiamo.
Voi avete.
Voi avete.
Loro hanno.
Loro hanno.
Okay, so here I want to write some word that we can use, and I write fame, sete, sonno, caldo, and freddo, caldo, freddo, and then I tell you the meaning, of course, caldo, freddo, paura. Okay, let's see the meaning. So, fame is hungry. Hungry. Sete is thirsty. Thirsty. So you wanna drink. Sonno is sleepy. Caldo is hot. Freddo is cold. And paura is fear. Okay. So the way in Italian you say I am hungry is, pay attention, look, io ho fame. You take this one and you add the one with hungry. So you say, if you say io ho fame, it means I am hungry. If you say tu hai fame, it means you are hungry. If you say lui ha fame, it means he is hungry. Lei ha fame, I'm doing the number one here. Lei ha fame is she is hungry. Then noi abbiamo fame is we are hungry. Voi avete fame is you guys o y'all are hungry. Loro hanno fame, it means they are hungry. Does it make sense? Good. Now, the same with the sete. But this time, you don't say I'm hungry, you say I'm thirsty. So, if you want to say I'm thirsty, you say, now I put the subject here, but Italian don't say the subject, but we use it for now. So, if instead to say io ho fame, I say io ho sete means I am thirsty. So, io ho sete, I am thirsty. Tu hai sete, you are thirsty. Lui ha sete, he is thirsty. You understand? And then there is sonno. Sonno means sleepy. For example, if I want to say I am sleepy. Okay? So, let's see how to build this sentence in Italian. First of all, I am. So I do because in Italian you use the verb to have. You don't use to am. So I am sleepy. You use the first one that corresponds to I have and is io ho. And then sleepy is this one, right? Sonno. So io ho sonno. Let's say that you want to say she feels cold, okay? So she feel cold because it's cold, it's winter. So, she is this one, lei is this one, because lei means she. So, you write lei, a, so you copy the one that is written here. And then you look where is cold, oh, look, is here. So, lei ha freddo. For example, try to say, first of all, let's repeat the verb. Can you repeat the verb after me? So, avere.
Avere.
Io ho.
Io ho. Io ho.
Tu hai.
Tu hai.
Lui ha.
Lui ha.
Lei ha.
Lei ha. Lei ha.
Noi abbiamo.
Noi abbiamo.
Voi avete.
Voi avete.
Loro hanno.
Loro hanno.
So now let's repeat those one. Fame.
Fame.
Sete.
Sete.
Sonno.
Sonno.
Caldo.
Caldo.
Freddo. Paura.
Paura.
Yes. So now I want to tell you, try, for example, I would you say I am hungry. Which one of those you choose to say I am?
Fem.
The first one, right?
Yeah, fem.
So, I am hungry is gonna be, let me, no, I think.
I uno.
Sì, exactly, but I think I'm gonna write it in another way because it's probably a little confusing like this. So Here I'm gonna write so the first one here is gonna be this is I. So when you wanna say I, you go here. When you wanna say you, you use this one. When you wanna say he, this one. She is this one. Then we is this one. That y'all or use guys is this one. And they is this one, okay? And that's it. So let's say, how would you say I am hungry? Which one of those you choose? The one where there is I, right? So io ho.
Yeah, I. Yeah.
Io ho fame.
So you have to say io ho fame.
Yes. Well, Italians don't use the subject. I'm just using because when people learn, it's good that you learn also the subject. My Italian is like in Spanish. An Italian wouldn't say io ho fame. They only say ho fame.
Oh, you mean Italian just say ho fame, right?
They say only ho fame, but I teach with the subject in the beginning because I want the student to understand that the subject exists. It's just implied. It's hidden, but the subject is there.
Mm-hmm.
So an Italian will say ho fame.
Mm-hmm.
Ho fame, ho sete. So ho fame, ho sete. Sì, ho sonno, ho fame. Cioè, if you talk in the first person, you say I, you use ho with all of this. So, say after me, ho fame.
Ho fame.
Ho sete.
Ho sete.
Ho sonno.
Ho sonno.
Ho caldo.
Ho caldo.
Ho freddo.
Ho freddo.
Ho paura.
Ho paura.
So, would that mean so fame?
Ho fame means I'm hungry.
Very good. So you remember a little bit. If I say ho sete, you remember
that means
thirsty. If I say ho sonno,
sleepy.
Ho caldo,
hot.
Ho freddo,
cold.
Ho paura,
fear.
Paura means fear.
Yes.
And the Italian use the verb to have because the Italian don't say I'm hungry. They say I have a hanger. That's why they use the verb to have. The translation of this, a perfect literal translation is I have a hanger. I have a thirst.
Okay.
So you can also ask to someone if they are hangry. For example, instead to use o, you use I, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And if instead to use o, you use I, you can ask, because in Italian, to ask a question, there isn't do and does, like in English. It's just the intonation of the voice. So if you say to your son or to your husband, to whatever, you say, I fame, it means, are you hungry?
Mm-hmm.
Try to do it with the intonation of the voice to see that is a question. Hai fame?
I'm fame.
Yes. Yeah, it's like asking, no? Are you hungry?
Okay.
You
the
see
first
what
one, the first one was what? Ono fame?
What did you say?
The first one was I'm hungry. How do you say I'm hungry?
Instead of I, you use o. If you say o, it means I am hungry. If you say I, it means you are hungry.
Yeah.
So ho fame, I am hungry.
I
fame, you are hungry.
Okay.
But you can put it as a question. Instead of I fame, you say I fame. You do like a music with your voice, no? Hai fame? And that means, are you hungry?
Mm-hmm. Hai fame?
Yes. And if I ask you, hai fame, you can say, you can answer me and say, sì, ho fame. Yes, I'm hungry. Or you can say, no, comma, non ho fame. So, no, I'm not hungry.
Okay.
Does it make sense?
Yeah.
So let's do a little bit of this exercise. Here I'm going to ask you, hai fame, hai sete, hai sonno, and you are going to answer me, sì, comma, o blank, o no, comma, non, o blank. And here also is blank. So, for example, if I ask you, hai fame, it means that you need to use the word fame. If you want to answer, yes, I'm hungry, you say sì, ho fame. You put fame in the blank. Or if you want to tell me, no, I'm not hungry, use the second. No, non ho fame.
Okay.
You,
okay.
So we use it as a model. This is the question that I ask you, okay? Yes. And this is the answer.
Answer.
Where there is the blank, you can put any one of these.
There.
So okay. You want to try? Now, yes. I ask you, hai sete?
No, non ho sete. Non sete.
Yes, we can delete that because it's confusing. Because it is, you can just say non ho sete. Because non is like don't. Is the negation. It's like to say don't. I don't have. I'm not.
Okay.
Is the non in Italian is used to make a sentence negative. Instead, in English, you use don't.
Okay.
In Italian, you use don't. Yes. If you say ho sete means I'm thirsty. If you say non ho sete is I'm not thirsty. Okay. So let's try another one. Hai sonno?
Non sonno.
Non ho sonno, very good. It means I'm not sleepy.
Non ho sonno.
The H is muted, so you read like O. Non ho sonno.
Non ho sonno.
Very good.
Non ho sonno.
That's dude, brava. In Italian, when someone do well, they say bravo. If he's a man, if you were a man, I would say bravo. But because you are a girl, I say brava. Brava, yeah. Brava. It means good, good job.
Okay.
Brava.
Brava.
Yes. So now let's do, hai caldo?
Mm-hmm.
So which one you will say? Are you, you feel warm?
What did you say?
Hai caldo? This one, hai caldo?
Okay, non ho caldo.
Very good, brava.
Okay.
Hai freddo?
Non ho freddo, brava.
Brava, I say brava to you.
Brava is good job.
Good job.
Okay.
So when you do it right, I tell you, good job.
You tell me, okay.
I tell you. Hai paura?
Okay. Non ho paura.
This is
non
difficult.
Ho paura.
To pronounce these words is difficult. Paura.
Paura. Non ho paura.
Brava. Bene. We finished the 1 hour.
So I'm right. Non ho paura.
Yes, you say pretty well. Your pronunciation is pretty good.
It's pretty. Trying my best, yeah.
Your pronunciation is pretty good. Yes, paura. No. You say correct.
No, freddo. No, caldo.
Let's do it one more time. Hai fame?
Yeah, non ho fame.
Hai sete?
Non ho sete.
Hai sonno?
Non ho sonno.
Hai caldo?
Non ho caldo.
Hai freddo?
Non ho freddo.
Hai paura?
Non ho paura.
Now you ask me if I'm hungry. So ask me, hai fame? Ask me all of those and I answer.
Oh, okay. Now.
So you say, hai fame, hai sete. So start with the first. Hai.
Is it I of famine?
No, you say I fame because O is to say I.
Okay.
You now ask me. So you ask question. Me. Yes, yeah. It's the question. You ask me. Question. You are hungry. Yeah. So it's just.
I famine.
Of fame.
I of famine.
No, I without O. Only I. Because or it means I am hungry. So you are asking me. So you just say I. So don't say oh.
Okay. So I famine.
Non ho fame.
Okay. I sete.
Non ho sete.
I sonano.
Sonno.
Oh, I sono.
Non ho sonno.
I con
caldo.
Oh, hai caldo?
Non ho caldo.
Hai
freddo?
Hai freddo?
Non ho freddo.
Hai
paura? Paura.
Paura?
Non ho paura.
You say no, no.
No, no. Like, I don't.
Oh, okay. No, okay.
Non ho paura. I don't.
Okay. Brava.
Grazie. How do you feel? It was difficult.
But it takes, you know, the first day I think it's normal. I'm going to look through, you know.
Yes, but you know, the most difficult to learn a language is the first lessons. Because when you don't know anything and everything is new, you have also to learn grammar.
Keep your cash, I'm not that broke. I won't sign no contracts, I do me. Y'all are canceled, stealing people's dreams. How can you sleep? It's alright.